Hey everybody, this is Allie Craig here for Empire Magazine. And on this week's episode of Little Black Book of Branding, let's talk about the five ways to use your quirks to your brand advantage. Yeah, all those things that you think you should hide, you should maybe minimize. The truth is that those quirks can actually be the best branding tools you have in your branding arsenal. Let's talk about when, where, and why. Number one, your brand experience. Yes, your overall brand experience should show your quirks, should show your personality. Why? Because this brand is all about building a relationship, and the brand is what's bringing you and your audience together. So by having your personality in your brand experience overall, then your audience already can begin to know if they like you, and they can already get to know and perceive who you are and who your customers are or who your staff is. And so therefore can kind of get a little snapshot, a little taste before they actually enter the brand. So yes, use your quirks in your brand experience, which also means number two, use your quirks in your copy. Marketing copy and all that jazz needs to have the way you speak, the way you think infused into it. So stop editing yourself. Seriously, add the quirkiness, add the words you're making up, add the way you perceive it, the examples, all of that, because it's those little originalities that will make your brand stand apart. Add your quirks into your touch points. So whatever that looks like online, offline, when it comes to your outreach, if it comes to how you package something or how you mail something or what your welcome box is or how you send an invoice, even if it's an email invoice, make sure your quirks stand out. The most fun brands, even online brands that we have, are the ones that show their personality, like MailChimp with their little chimpy sayings, Activity Scheduler with their fun little quirks and wisdom in the way that they say, oh, you got to sign back in again. So guess what? Use your expressions to your advantage when it comes to any of the touch points you're building for your brand online and offline. Number four, all of your outreach, especially your social media outreach. Far too often, we don't look at social media as an outreach platform, but that's really what it is. So put your personality into that. Choose the photos that you like that, of course, are still on brand. Share your sayings, your expressions, your motivations, your behind the scenes with people. Yes, inspirational quotes by Maya Angelou are lovely and great, but everyone else does it too. But not everyone has your expressions and your way of thinking. So share that. Lastly, you. Simple as that. The way you work, put your quirks into the entire process that it is to work, to be with you. If that's selling a product, if that's working with a client one-on-one as a consultant, whatever it is, you have to infuse who you are in all of that you're doing, all of the processes that you're doing. If you're the one doing all the processes, AKA selling and actually implementing the work, or even if you're training a team, the truth is that your team needs to have a universal platform to build off of. That universal platform needs to have an awful lot of you in the mix. So that way, no matter if your new client is talking to a team member or talking to you, the impression and the experience is consistent and, more importantly, on brand all the time. Use your quirks to your brand's advantage because they're your quirks and no one else's. So that way, none of your competition could ever replicate it. They may try to imitate it, but they surely won't succeed at being the fabulous you that you are.